Hi friends, in this video we are going to see power consumed in a three-phase circuit. In AC circuit, power is given as voltage multiplied by current. Rather, in DC also the same expression is true. But in AC circuit we have three types of powers, namely P, Q and S. P is called as active, real or true power, Q is reactive power and S is apparent power. All these three powers are present in a circuit. So let's list out one by one. First is active, real or true power. It is given as P equal to 3 VPH IPH cos phi PH. VPH IPH cos phi PH is the power consumed by a single phase circuit, but it's a 3 phase, therefore multiplication by 3. Same expression we can write in terms of line quantities also. So in terms of line quantities, P is root 3 VL IL cos phi PH. One thing you have to remember over here, phi PH here as well as here is same, and that is nothing but angle between VPH and IPH. So the problem with this expression is, here you are considering a line quantities, but whenever you consider angle, that is not between VL and IL, but it is between VPH and IPH. So any whichever way, you should know where is the VPH and IPH in order to get phi PH. So better we use this expression, because here everything is a phase quantity. The unit of active, real or true power is watt or kilowatt, or sometimes we go higher unit, that is megawatt. Let's go to second type of power, that is reactive power. That is given as Q equal to 3 VPH IPH sin phi PH. Once again you can write this in terms of line quantities, root 3 VL IL sin phi PH. Same story repeats over here, phi PH is the angle between VPH and IPH, hence better we remember this expression. Unit for reactive power is volt ampere reactive or kilovolt ampere reactive, or higher unit you can consider mega volt ampere reactive. Let's go to third type of power, that is apparent power. It is given by S equal to 3 times VPH into IPH. In terms of line quantities, S equal to root 3 VL into IL. Unit for apparent power is volt ampere or kilovolt ampere or mega volt ampere. Now let's draw a power triangle with the help of this. So let's consider first inductive circuit. And then capacitive circuit. So the power triangle for inductive circuit will be like this. This is P, this is Q, and hypotenuse is S. Phase angle phi is the angle between S and P. Already we discussed this P is 3 VPH IPH cos phi PH, or cos phi you can say. Q is 3 VPH IPH sin phi PH or sin phi, and S is 3 VPH IPH. And here phi is the phase angle, cos of phi will be the power factor. It's an inductive circuit, hence the nature will be lagging. That means current lags voltage by angle phi. Obviously, current and voltage here are the phase quantities. For capacitive circuit, the power triangle will be like this. Once again, P is active power given by 3 VPH IPH cos phi PH or cos phi. Q is 3 VPH IPH sin phi, and S is 3 VPH IPH. Phi, once again, a power factor angle or phase angle, and cos of it is power factor. It's a capacitive circuit, hence the nature is leading. So here we have seen a three phase power and power triangle associated with inductive as well as capacitive circuit. Thank you.